People say that life is a journey. But we believe that it is through journeys itself that we actually experience life. It's on these journeys that we learn how to laugh, how to enjoy solitude, and how to enjoy the beauty and music that is all around us. So every week, we will be taking you on a journey. A journey to different places in India, as well as journeys into the lives of some of the most interesting people we know. So join us on the crowded highways, the little lanes and the winding roads, as we journey to discover India. Welcome to Follow the Star, the show where we discover India through its highways. And today, I am going to be journeying through a milieu of historical towns on my way to the Great Run of Kutch. This time around, I am in the vibrant state of Gujarat. My journey will be divided into two parts, which we will cover driving on one national highway and one state highway. Today, I will be driving on the National Highway 8A from Morbi to Mandvi, covering a distance of 216 kilometers. The second leg of my journey will be from Mandvi to the Run of Kutch, for which I will take on the State Highway 45. The total distance of our journey will be 350 kilometers. NH8 or National Highway 8 is part of the Golden Quadrilateral Project and is the busiest highway in the subcontinent as it connects the national capital Delhi to the financial capital Mumbai, as well as important cities like Gurgaon, Ajmer, Udaipur, Ahmedabad, Surat, Jaipur and Vadodara. The total length is 1375 kilometers. I start today's journey at the Darbargarh Palace in Morbi. This 19th century palace was once the residence of the royal family of Morbi. Today, the palace serves as a heritage hotel and spreads out all the glory and magnificence of a century made eternal by the patronage of Maharajas.
The best way to flag off a road journey is to start off bright and early. And there can't be a better way to do justice to a beautiful morning like this. I'm in the royal town of Morbi at the Darbargarh Palace with my dependable B-class and a highway that summons me.
Morbi was once a princely state ruled by the Jadeja clan of Rajputs until Indian independence in 1947. There are some wonderful tourist places to see in Morbi, like the Jhulta Pul and the Mani Mandir. The place is a must visit for travellers looking to experience unique tourist destinations in Gujarat. I have been driving non-stop since we left Morbi. The road conditions in Gujarat are more than commendable. In such splendid roads, the driving experience can be nothing but joyous. A 100 kilometers is the exact distance we've covered till now, and I'm not tired, nor am I bored. The Mercedes B180 doesn't let you feel anything but happiness. This particular belt falls under the salt pan zone, and the roads leading up to the city of Anjar are lined with salt fields where the mineral is extracted from groundwater.
I'm just entering Anjar. This was one of the towns to be majorly affected by the Bhuj earthquake.
Anjar is well known for its cuisine, especially the Bikrani Dabeli, and that is exactly why I'm stopping here. Originating in the Kutch region of Gujarat, Dabeli is a spicy snack which resembles the famous burger. Dabeli today is famous not only in Kutch and Gujarat, but also throughout Maharashtra and many other states of India.
When you're in these parts of Gujarat, it's a must to stop at street stalls like this selling Dabeli. That's exactly where I am right now, and I'm going to treat myself to one.
After that spicy treat, it's time for me to get back on the highway and continue towards my destination. The temperature is soaring and the scorching heat is increasing with every passing minute. But thanks to the powerful air conditioning of the Mercedes B180, I don't need to sweat.
The highways in Gujarat are simply superb. The roads are wide, extremely well maintained, and the drivers are most disciplined. The state highways equally match up to the national highways.
Leaving the towns of Morbi and Anjar behind, I'm nearing my final destination, Mandvi. The roads till now have been splendid and the drive, brilliant.
To head to Mandvi, I need to take a right turn here, while straight ahead is Mundra, one of India's largest private ports.
Mandvi was once a major port and summer retreat for the King of Kutch. The city has a 400-year-old shipbuilding industry, which was started by the Kharwa people, who still build ships here. Kharwa community's patron saint of sorts, Daryalal's temple, houses memorial stones of seafarers who lost their lives at sea. Up ahead, I begin my exploration of the beautiful town of Mandvi, where I visit a freedom fighter's memorial and meet up with a very interesting seaman who shares some fascinating sea tales with me.